Hey guys, so today we'll be taking a look at the second most popular Kata or code challenge on Codewars. So let's sort by popularity and go down to the second problem, which is multiples of 3 or 5. Okay, so the instructions are finish the solution so that it returns the sum of all the multiples of 3 or 5 below the number passed in. Additionally, if the number is negative, return 0. Okay, so there's 3 main ways of solving this problem. Let's start with the most standard method. For this solution, we want to loop through all the positive numbers below the number passed into the function. And if a number is a multiple of either 3 or 5, which we can determine using the modulus operator, we add it to the total. We then return the total once we are done with our loop. Okay, perfect. Now let's try again and solve this problem in a more Pythonic fashion. This time we can shorten our code down to one line by taking advantage of Python's built-in sum function and generator expressions. If you're not familiar with generator expressions, just know that they have the same structure as list comprehensions, but without the square brackets. So, similar to our first solution, we want the sum of all the numbers below the argument, that is, a multiple of 3 or 5. Alright, now let's take a look at the third method. This will be the most efficient solution compared to the previous two because we'll be using a more mathematical approach instead of looping through every single number. The general idea here is to add together the sum of all the multiples of 3 and the sum of all the multiples of 5, and then from that, subtract all the multiples of 15. We need to do this subtraction because when we're adding numbers that are multiples of 3 and 5, we could be adding some duplicate numbers in the sum. Okay, so to start, we need to get a count of how many numbers are a multiple of 3, 5, and 15. Now to get the sum of all the multiples of, say, 3, we need to multiply 3 by the sum of 1 through n, where n is the count. And for the sum of 1 through n, we can simply use the formula n times n plus 1 divided by 2. Finally, we need to remember to return 0 for negative arguments. Alright, and that's it. Please let me know if you would like a more detailed explanation of any of the solutions, especially the third solution. Feel free to leave your questions in the comment section below, and of course remember to like and subscribe for the next Codewars challenge. Thanks!